the dichotomy between kinematic and dynamic waves and its relation to scale has defied complete understanding in the past. The matter has been elucidated by Ponce and Simons in 1977, who identified the appropriate dimensionless wave number and plotted dimensionless relative wave celerities across the spectrum of dimensionless wave numbers. In addition, they clarify the propagation characteristics of various types of shallow water waves, including their celerity and attenuation properties. Herein, we review the Ponce and Simons theory and explain its significance. The aim is to showcase the importance of wave propagation in hydraulic engineering modeling practice. Shallow wave propagation in open channel flow is governed by the equations of water continuity and motion, generally referred to as the Saint-Venant equations. These are a set of two partial differential equations for which there is no complete analytical solution. This theoretical difficulty was circumvented by Ponce and Simons, who linearized the governing equations and applied the tools of linear stability to formulate a characteristic algebraic equation which retained the essence of the solution. The proper definition of dimensionless wave number allowed the calculation of celerity and attenuation functions across the entire spatial domain. The results describe wave propagation for several types of shallow waves, throwing much needed light on the wave phenomena. There are four forces in the analysis of unsteady open channel flow. 1. Gravitational, or gravity. 2. Bottom friction, or friction. 3. Pressure gradient. And 4. Inertial, or inertia. Four types of shallow water waves are in general use. 1. Kinematic. 2. Diffusion. 3. Mixed kinematic dynamic. And 4. Dynamic. Kinematic waves are governed solely by gravity and friction. Diffusion waves by gravity, friction, and the pressure gradient. Mixed kinematic dynamic waves by all four forces, namely gravity, friction, the pressure gradient, and inertia. And dynamic waves solely by the pressure gradient and inertia. At the outset, it is necessary to point out that there exists currently a semantic confusion regarding what to call the different types of waves. What we call here mixed kinematic dynamic waves have been generally referred to in the literature as dynamic, following the work of Fred, 1973. On the other hand, the classical dynamic waves, that is, the dynamic waves of Lagrange, have been often referred to as gravity waves. In this work, we follow the naming indicated in column 2 of table 1, in an effort to settle the semantic confusion. The term kinematic wave was introduced by Lighthill and Whittam in their seminal paper, purportedly to contrast the then well-established dynamic waves, which transport energy, to waves that transport mass. We quote here directly from Lighthill and Whittam. Classical dynamic waves transport only energy. Therefore, it follows that mixed kinematic dynamic waves transport both mass and energy. In the resolution of this dichotomy may lie the strong attenuating, that is, dissipating, tendency of mixed kinematic dynamic waves. Ponce and Simons plotted dimensionless relative wave celerities across the spectrum of dimensionless wave numbers and specialized their finding into each one of the four wave types described in Table 1. Crucial to this effort was the identification of the dimensionless wave number sigma star, in which L sub O is the characteristic reach length, that is, the length of channel in which the steady uniform flow drops a head equal to its depth, in which D sub O is the steady uniform flow depth, and S sub O is the channel bed slope. Figure 4 shows dimensionless relative wave celerities across the dimensionless wave number spectrum. Given C equal wave celerity, the relative wave celerity C sub R is, in which U sub O is the steady uniform flow velocity. The dimensionless relative wave celerity C sub R star is. Figure 4 comprises the fundamental finding of Ponce and Simons. This figure shows values of dimensionless relative wave celerities versus dimensionless wave numbers as calculated by the theory. The range in dimensionless wave numbers shown spans six orders of magnitude, encompassing from the longest waves, kinematic of small sigma star, to the shortest waves, dynamic of large sigma star. Herein, we refer to figure 4 as the S-curve. All four wave types, kinematic, diffusion, mixed kinematic dynamic, and dynamic, are contained in the S-curve. Kinematic waves are governed solely by gravity and friction. Their celerity is constant and equal to the kinematic wave celerity, or Seddon celerity, and they do not attenuate, with some exceptions for nonlinear waves. The Seddon celerity is, in which T is the channel top width, Q the discharge, and Y the flow depth. The Seddon or kinematic wave celerity is alternatively expressed as follows, in which beta is the exponent of the discharge flow area rating. The relative kinematic wave celerity, or kinematic wave celerity relative to the flow velocity, is. The dimensionless relative kinematic wave celerity is. The value of beta is a function of channel friction and cross-sectional shape. For chassis friction in a hydraulically wide channel, beta is equal to 1.5. In this case, the dimensionless relative kinematic wave celerity is 0.5. For Froude numbers in the stable regime, F is less than or equal to 2, which corresponds to Vedernikov numbers V less than or equal to 1. Figure 4 shows the range of dimensionless wave numbers for which kinematic waves prevail. Sigma star greater than 0.001 and less than 0.1. For Froude and Vedernikov numbers in the unstable regime, F greater than 2 or V greater than 1, the range is somewhat reduced, as shown to the left of figure 4. In the Ponce and Simons theory, wave attenuation is a function of the change in relative dimensionless wave celerity with change in dimensionless wave number. In other words, attenuation is caused by the change in celerity with wave size. For the case of derivative of C sub R star with respect to sigma star equal to zero, there can be no wave attenuation. Therefore, kinematic waves do not attenuate. The above conclusion, while strong, is strictly valid only for the linear theory. In the general nonlinear case, kinematic waves may undergo changes in shape, either steepening or flattening, depending on the local hydraulics, mostly the interaction with the cross-sectional shape. In the case of steepening, this eventually leads to a kinematic shock, while in the case of flattening, the situation resembles wave attenuation. In summary, kinematic waves travel with the Seddon celerity, and in general, they are not subject to attenuation. The condition of a wave being kinematic depends on the dimensionless wave number, with the wave becoming more kinematic as sigma star decreases. See figure 4 for the appropriate values. The criterion for the applicability of a kinematic wave in open channel flow has been developed by Ponce et al., 1978. For 95% accuracy after one propagation period, the following dimensionless inequality holds, in which T is the wave period, S sub O is the bed slope, U sub O is the mean velocity, and D sub O is the mean flow depth. Diffusion waves are governed by gravity, friction, and the pressure gradient. The inclusion of the pressure gradient in the formulation of a diffusion wave provides diffusion, that is, the wave is capable of undergoing attenuation or dissipation, therein its name, diffusion wave. The origin of the name may be traced back to the work of Lighthill and Whittam, 1955, who reckoned that diffusion could be added to a kinematic wave by including the pressure gradient term in the formulation. In Ponce and Simons' theory, the celerity of a diffusion wave is, as an approximation, the same as that of the neighboring kinematic wave in the dimensionless wave number spectrum. The difference is in the attenuation function. Unlike the kinematic wave, for which the attenuation is zero, the diffusion wave is subject to a small but finite amount of attenuation. The attenuation is a function of the dimensionless wave number sigma star, and, as expected, increases with it. To characterize the magnitude of the wave attenuation, Ponce and Simons used the logarithmic decrement delta, which measures the attenuation after one sinusoidal propagation period. For the diffusion wave, the logarithmic decrement is, which reduces to delta sub d tending to zero as sigma star tends to zero, thus coalescing into a kinematic wave. A diffusion wave has a wider range of applicability than a kinematic wave. In cases where a kinematic wave fails, a diffusion wave may be applicable. The criterion for the applicability of a diffusion wave has been developed by Ponce et al., 1978. The criterion is based on the following dimensionless inequality, in which g is the gravitational acceleration. In Figure 4, diffusion waves would fall to the right of kinematic waves, in the middle of the dimensionless wave number range, 0.1 less than or equal to sigma star less than or equal to 10, depending on the Froude number. The lower the prevailing Froude number in the stable range, f less than or equal to 2, the greater the range of applicability of diffusion waves. Mixed kinematic dynamic waves are governed by all four forces, gravity, friction, pressure gradient, and inertia. As such, a mixed kinematic dynamic wave represents the most complete formulation of shallow water waves in open channel flow. However, it is not without its pitfalls. Under typical subcritical flow conditions, mixed kinematic dynamic waves are subject to very strong attenuation, to the extent that often their existence may be placed into question. This fact was recognized by Lighthill and Whittam, 1955, when they stated, under the conditions appropriate for flood waves, the dynamic waves rapidly become negligible, and it is the kinematic waves, following at a slower speed, which assume the dominant role. Thus, the mixed kinematic dynamic waves, lying directly on the rising limb of the S-curve, are generally subject to very strong attenuation. The rate of attenuation increases with the rise on the curve, achieving a peak at the point of inflection. These propositions were demonstrated by Ponce and Simons in their analysis of the mixed kinematic dynamic wave model. The results are summarized in figures 4, 6, 7, and 8. The following conclusions are drawn from figure 4. The mixed kinematic dynamic waves lie in between the kinematic waves to the left of the wave number spectrum and the dynamic waves to the right. The mixed kinematic dynamic waves are subject to very strong attenuation. For Froude number F equal to 2, corresponding to Veternikov number V equal to 1, under Chesley friction in a hydraulically wide channel, all waves travel with the same celerity. The following conclusions are drawn from figure 6. In the stable range of Froude numbers, F less than 2, corresponding to Veternikov numbers, V less than 1, the primary wave attenuation function peaks around the middle to right of the wave number spectrum. Primary wave attenuation is clearly stronger as the Froude number decreases in the subcritical regime. The following conclusions are drawn from figure 7. In the unstable range of Froude numbers F greater than 2, corresponding to Veternikov numbers V greater than 1, the primary wave amplification function peaks around the middle to left of the wave number spectrum. Primary wave amplification is somewhat stronger as the Froude number increases in the supercritical regime. The following conclusions are drawn from Figure 8. In the subcritical flow regime, secondary wave attenuation increases sharply to infinity to the right of the mid-range of dimensionless wave numbers. In the critical flow regime, secondary wave attenuation reaches a minimum at the mid-range of dimensionless wave numbers. In the supercritical flow regime, secondary wave attenuation decreases from high values in the kinematic range to low values in the dynamic range. In summary, the findings of Ponce and Simons, 1977, serve to clarify the relation between kinematic and mixed kinematic dynamic waves. While the former do not attenuate, the latter are subject to very strong attenuation, particularly in the subcritical regime, where it matters most. Kinematic waves are applicable to overland flow and flood routing. Mixed kinematic dynamic waves are primarily applicable to dam breach flood waves, and in unusual cases, to flood routing. Diffusion waves lying in between kinematic and mixed kinematic dynamic waves have small amounts of diffusion and are therefore able to properly simulate flood waves. The dynamic waves of classical mechanics are governed solely by the pressure gradient and inertia. They lie to the right of the dimensionless wave number spectrum, corresponding to the top of the S-curve. For the most part, their celerity is constant and equal to the dynamic wave celerity, or classical Lagrange celerity, expressed as follows. This equation reveals the two components of dynamic wave propagation. The relative dynamic wave celerity is. The dimensionless relative dynamic wave celerity is, which is recognized as the reciprocal of the Froude number. This equation is represented in Figure 4. For instance, for Froude number f equal to 0.1, the pink curve, the value of dimensionless relative wave celerity approaches 10 to the right of the scale. The following conclusions regarding dynamic waves are drawn from Figure 4. The celerity of a dynamic wave is constant and independent of scale, that is, of dimensionless wave number. The attenuation of a dynamic wave is zero, that is, dynamic waves do not attenuate in one-dimensional flow. At Froude number f equal 2, which corresponds to Vedernikov number v equal 1, the celerity of dynamic waves equals that of kinematic waves. At this point, the flow is neutrally stable, that is, at the threshold of flow instability. The condition v greater than 1 is necessary but not sufficient for the formation of roll waves. The theory of shallow wave propagation of Ponce and Simons, 1977, is reviewed and clarified with aim to showcase its importance in understanding the mechanics of unsteady open channel flow. Four forces are identified at the outset: gravity, friction, pressure gradient, and inertia. These forces give rise to several practical wave combinations, enabling the definition of the following types of shallow waves. 1. Kinematic. 1A. Diffusion. 2. Mixed kinematic dynamic. And 3. Dynamic. The propagation characteristics of these wave types, including celerity and attenuation functions, are described and explained in detail using graphical aids. Elucidation of the theory should make possible increased understanding and lead to better modeling practice.